been this excited for a lecture in a long time. I've had people say, are you in the porn industry? It's medical demonics. So I grew up thinking I was stupid. I didn't process information well. What happened, though, was after high school, I went into the Marine Corps. And over in Desert Storm in 1991, my job as a dragon gunner was to blow up enemy tanks. So we had to identify, is this a good tank or a bad tank? My biggest liability, how I learned, turned out to be one of my greatest assets. It's amazing how God works, right? I hated you in high school. I hated you. I probably hate you now still. And the cognitive density was very high. The stakes were high. The consequences were really high. How I performed in the ER, and these concepts of thought and ethical behavior, how I think about patients, it became very personal. I started overlapping, going, wait a second, I do that sometimes. Out of 3 years, we started with $40,000. Last year, our total revenue was $1.1 million in 3 years. I hope you leave here with real tools to change how you think at your job, transformative tools. All I hope this lecture is a catalyst for thought to challenge yourselves on how you can be better and to transform how I behave spiritually, how I behave in my marriage, and without question transform my business. It's proof against all arguments. You can use this anytime you want to, as often as you want to, 20 times a day, 30 times a day. It's going to keep you ignorant. You can use it. That principle is contempt prior to investigation. You'll get better, but if you change your thinking, you have huge paradigm changes, it will make measurable differences in your work, and I've gone through that, I have experienced it. But when it's your kid, oh my God, I didn't want to do it, oh my God, I was an idiot, right? I don't know, right? As calm as I can outside, but underneath the water, it's like a duck sitting in the water, but the legs are going like this, my mind's, oh, better be 100% into my kid's eye right now. Don't tell me you gotta get out of here in 25 minutes because you got a golf game, I'll kill you. I will lose profit to do the right thing. Heuristics. Heuristics are mental shortcuts. They're cognitive things that we do to make life easier for ourselves. There's ways that we think that are traps, that we'll get presented with a situation, we think it's the same situation that we've dealt with hundreds of times before, but something's slightly off and we don't acknowledge it. So, when you're in a situation that things are getting a little cluttered, if anything I share with you today starts to start filtering itself in, you go, wait a second, is this appropriate or not? Am I thinking right? Take your right pointer finger and push your nose. And what it does is it clears your whole brain, and now you can rethink about it. Actually, everybody do that. Take your right pointer finger, put it up. Right pointer finger, Kevin, you too. Put your right pointer, now push your nose. Push your nose. And go, am I okay with this? Don't get sucked into the system. Go, wait a second, am I okay with what's going on here? I'm pressured and I can't do as good of a job as I want to because I'm too busy. So if you have a baby and they sneak up and go, they get so many points, you can't help them. You're judging. Psst, oh, this guy, huh? Psst, there it is! Where you guys seen a bunny rabbit? There's no bunny rabbit in there! It's in the pad, isn't it?
It is.
It looks like a bunny in a
pan.
It was cognitive. Okay, that's good. Cognitive thinking. We'll get a free DVD of this lecture. What would you guess my blood sugar would be? What do you think?
240.
What other choices? What else do you think? So that's, I'm going to check it. We'll see who get close. I'll get two more answers. 240. What do you think?
Can you ask questions?
No. Just give me a number. What do you think?
200.
Who else? What else? What do you think?
225.
Okay. Here's the thing, I'm not a diabetic, so my blood sugar better not be that high, but I anchored you on the number 240, so you estimate high because you're like, well, John said 240, so it's got to be close. Why did I get a truck? I don't know. I bought this truck. I wanted a truck, right? And my wife's like, why do you want a truck? I'm like, oh, get to haul stuff in it. And I might move stuff for work, so I need a truck. It snows in Buffalo. I might have to pull someone out of it. Don't you think this? Yeah! Oh, see? Ben said so, hon. See? I know that I'm extremely limited within my business, and I will always have a coach. I will always have somebody who's standing outside looking in. I call it bell jar thinking. And Sylvia Platt talked about that. You put a bell jar overhead, and you're talking, you're giving your own thoughts, but you're inhaling your own hot air. You're inhaling your own decisions. You're shot. Oh, shit! You guys have done it. We don't do that, John. If my visceral response is on the extreme, I step back, push my reset button, and say, no question, it's the foundation for what made my business grow from a $40,000 business 3 years ago when I'm borrowing money to a $1.1 million. And I think we're going to go over $2 million this year. I find that I have a lot of ideas, only about 10% of them are good. But I run these ideas by my team and we get good feedback. So get a coach, push reset. Cool? Thank you guys. Good luck here.
Thank you.